This episode of How to Spin Yarn has been brought to you by SpinOlution, state-of-the-art spinning wheels proudly made by families in the USA. And by My Local Wool. Find farms, festivals, artisans, and shops near you by visiting mylocalwool.com. Hello and welcome back to Corespun. Let me grab a bobbin. In this video, we are going to be working with Corespinning different types of top and playing with texture and seeing what happens. I rarely Corespin top because I find that it's difficult to control, and I like to spin fast. So I like to spin fibers that I can control while I spin them quickly. So we're just going to see what happens. I'm using a commercial mohair thread for my core. I like this because it's strong. I can add a ton of twist in it without it getting rebellious, and it's got plenty of fibery texture for these tops to grab onto. Let's get ready. Okay, I'm going to introduce you to the fibers that we are going to be experimenting with. I want to try spinning a couple rolags today. I'm including these in tops because they are pre-drafted, and so I figured they will act similarly to top. So I've got two rolags that we're going to be playing with. I have some random, I think it's like a wool with cotton little slubs in it, some natural flax, some white flax, because you really can't have too much flax, and an alpaca silk. I think I'm going to start with the rolag. Okay, so we're going to tuck our core thread through the leader thread loop. Start spinning in a clockwise direction, and I'm just going to draft this rolag out and let it spin on at a 90 degree angle. So yeah, this is a wonderful fiber if you want a nice, even, easily controlled Corespun yarn. I am noticing that I'm having to hold my thread, so I'm going to wrap it around. Actually, I like wrapping it around my wrist. Excuse me. And that will create some drag, so it doesn't pull out of my hand as quickly. One thing I don't like about Corespinning top is that I often get these little bumps. So why not pretend that we want those? I don't want any ends sticking out, so make sure we secure. But yeah, if we draft a lot and then let it kind of rush or coil onto the thread, that creates a fun texture. Making sure that we're creating loops, almost like a boucle, without any torn ends sticking out. And this is just me saying, let's make a technique out of doing this really sloppy. That's how a lot of my ideas are formed. If I'm struggling or just not working, it's like, well, maybe there's a way to turn this into something fun. And I think that's pretty cool. If you're concerned about the stability of this yarn, which I might be, I don't think this yarn is sellable. It's just too fragile. Try plying it. And that will secure the texture. Just a simple thread ply at a 45 degree angle will really make this yarn feel more stable. Most of the time when I spin a yarn that I'm feeling kind of like it's, oh, that's, you know, it's beautiful. I don't want to ruin the fluffiness of it, but I don't think it's really stable. 9 times out of 10, I thread ply it. Almost to the end of this roulac. We're hitting the sparkle. You know it's a good day when you get to work with sparkle. If fiber could laugh, it would laugh in sparkle. Okay. That's really neat. Look, it's like a boucle, kind of. It's got loops and bumps, and I say that's success. Thread ply that. Use it for something. Let's now move on to natural flax. Flax has been, I think, one of my favorite fibers for this. Why am I plying? I'm spinning. Pardon me. Flax has been one of my favorite fibers for this series, just because it is so unexpected. Like even this, just a quick draft of top. How fun is that? Super fun. Flax just has personality. And no one puts flax in a corner. And no one controls flax. If you want practice making a yarn that you have no control over, use some flax. And do make sure that it doesn't get hooked on your hooks or your flyer pegs. Okay, let's move on to, we'll come back to the white flax. Let's move on to our cotton with the little, or not our cotton, our wool with the little cotton neps. So pinch it with the core and let it twist upon the core, and let's see if we can get a nice even. Not bad. Anytime you get a little tail sticking out, just kind of pinch and hold around it, and that will secure it and lock it in. So here's another one. You can just kind of sculpt it. Yeah, if you are a beginner, I recommend starting with just a wool your regular wool top. Let's try this alpaca silk and see what happens. It's another situation where I can tell, like, I'm getting bumps that I wouldn't really want. But let's live with them. Let's see what happens. See all those little beaded bumps? Maybe if, okay, so here's a thought. It's almost like we have to pinch and draft and hold really like a smooth and almost put a tiny bit of twist in it before, like it twists right here before it goes on the core thread. Like it's almost like it wants to be core spun. If you want that perfect look, it wants to be core spun at more of a 45 degree angle. But do you see what's happening? We're getting our core wrapped around it. So that's not working. Let's try changing hands. Ooh, this feels weird. Let's try drafting and core spinning from the opposite direction. And if you want to feel like a beginner again, change hands. I guess really if you're working with top and you want to create not super bumpy, slow and steady. That's the key. Slow and steady. Unfortunately, I've never been a slow and steady spinner. But perhaps getting that perfect top look is just a matter of practice and consistency. Because I already feel like I'm getting better and better and better as this yarn goes on. Yeah, it's just practice. It's practice and getting used to the fiber that you're working with. Because the consistency I'm getting now is 10 times better than when I started. If you're doing this for the first time and you really want that consistent look, make sure that your core thread matches the fiber that you're putting on the outside. That way, if you accidentally get your core thread wrapped around the outside of your yarn, it will blend in. It won't drive you nuts. Let's see if I can tilt my hand so you can see exactly how this is going on. Very smooth. A few mistakes, but I'm learning too. We're learning together. Okay, so I would say with practice, core spinning top is easy. Thank you. and fast. I'm actually kind of surprised at how fast I can go with this. Okay, let's go back to, let's do some natural flax, some white flax here. And I'm going to try the same thing. I'm going to try doing just kind of like a smooth rather than that bumpy. So if you look at my, this is where the core yarn is, and this is the fiber that's going on to it. And it is creating pretty much a 90 degree angle. And this section is also really forgiving because my fiber matches my core thread. So if I make a mistake, I can't see it. And that's nice. I like that. There we go. Very pretty. Maybe now that we've had all that practice, I'll go back into the rolag and see if I can get that this rolag to draft nice and smoothly. I think it's just practice, really. And I can tell I'm going to have issues with my thread being on top, as you can see. But I am getting a lot fewer bumps and mistakes. And I'm just letting all of these mistakes happen because I want you to see that it's okay to make mistakes and not worry about it. My goal is not to say, oh, here's 20 videos of me making perfect yarns. It's to say, let's do this together and learn together, because oftentimes I spin like my favorite 4 or 5 styles of yarns. Honestly, I think I just spin singles. At least for the past year, it's just been all thick and thin singles from Art Bats. And so going through this series and really breaking down these techniques, for me, a lot of it, I would say like 20% of it I've done for the first time. Like when I'm filming it, that's the first time I'm doing it too. Yeah, look at this. Nice. Nice, even, corespun yarn. Fabulous. Practice makes perfect. Okay, that's the end of the rolag, and that's the end of the yarn. Tie it in a knot, keeping it under tension so you don't lose your twist, and roll it up nice and tight on your bobbin so you can set it later. And that's the finished yarn. Looks really nice. Very cool.
Visit thisyarn.com for free patterns and projects exclusively designed for art yarns by art yarn spinners. What will you make with this yarn? If you have benefited from the education you received from my site and videos, pay it forward by making a donation on my website. Every donation goes toward my children's education. Thank you.